Okay, students, join in fast. Those who are facing any issue, please let me know. So, students, have you learned some new concept in center mark? Yes or no? I'm just asking about the chemistry. I don't know about other subjects. Definitely, you are learning in others also. Are you learning something new every time in center mark, at least in chemistry? Because in other subjects, they are following some different means. According to their subject only, they are following the process. But I try to put new things every time in center mark. So this time also related to acid and base, you will find new things. So be ready for that. Okay, students. So okay, so 1 minute, the students are joining. Just 1 more minute. Okay, students, anyone who is facing any issue, should we start the today's quiz? What do you say? Okay, that is start, sir. All thumbs up? Sure, should we start? Good, so today we'll have questions. I'll give you one hint what questions you are going to have. You will have questions on Lewis acid, Lewis base, Arrhenius acid, Arrhenius base, Bronsted acid, Bronsted base, first of all. Second thing, you will have a questions on hydrolysis. Hydrolysis related questions. I just want to tell one thing to all of you. Hydrolysis of only those salts undergo hydrolysis which are formed from weak acid and weak base. Keep this thing in mind. Those who don't know this part, just remember hydrolysis only happens for those salts which is formed by weak acid and weak base. This concept will be used in 2-3 questions. Okay, fine. So now I am going to start the quiz. Already, Lewis theory, yes, Lewis theory. There are 3 theories of acid, bases and salt. First theory is Lewis means. First is Arrhenius. Proton H plus donor is acid. OH minus donor is base. That is Arrhenius theory. What is Bronsted and Lowry theory? Proton acceptor is proton donor is acid. Proton acceptor is base. Okay. And the last one is Lewis theory. Lone pair acceptor is acid. Lone pair base is base. Don't worry, when I give you question, you will get to know. Okay, first question is in front of you. I'm starting the quiz. Don't worry, I'm starting. Okay, fine. Don't worry, Arena students, learn something new. It's very good for you. Which of the following does not undergo hydrolysis? Na2CO3, CH3COOH, CH3CO, NH4+, K2SO4. Which of the following does not undergo hydrolysis? I gave hint because I thought that many of you don't know about hydrolysis. That's why I gave hint. Aditya, I gave hint, still you don't know why. Okay, last 15 seconds. Okay, fine. Yes.
Okay, answer is D. Answer is B. Let us see how many of you have answered it right. Oh my God, after giving hint, you people are making mistake. Why? I just now I gave you hint and still you people are making mistake. Okay, fine. So I'll tell you. 1 minute, students. Okay. So, fine. So here is the question number one. Question is very easy. Hydrolysis happens for only those salts which are formed by weak acid and weak base. Na2CO3 is formed by NaOH plus H2CO3. Base is strong, but acid is weak acid. So it will hydrolyze. Okay, I want to tell what will hydrolyze. Always remember, you know, this is weak acid. Weak acid always dissociates like this. I think most of you know this. Weak acid always dissociate like this. So anion of weak acid is, if this is weak acid, anion is called as conjugate base. This is called as conjugate base. Now this undergo hydrolysis. Always remember, anion of weak acid undergo hydrolysis. If I ask you, there is something weak base. What thing will undergo hydrolysis? If there is a weak base, what thing undergo hydrolysis? Yes, metal ion or the cation. Very good. Anion undergo hydrolysis in case of weak acid, in case of weak base. Let's say here NH4 plus, here your base is NH4OH and acid is CH3COOH. This is acid, this is base. Weak base, weak acid. So what all things will going to hydrolyze? Tell me. I'm not going to tell you now. Which all things will going to hydrolyze in example 3? Which all things will going to hydrolyze? Think. In case of weak acid, conjugate base hydrolyze. So this is weak acid. What is the conjugate base of CH3COOH? What is the conjugate base of CH3COOH? Very good. CH3COO minus is conjugate base. So this will hydrolyze. So I will write CH3COO minus will hydrolyze. What will hydrolyze in your NH4OH? Don't write only NH4. It is wrong. NH4 plus. Weak acid, weak base. Here your conjugate acid will hydrolyze. Conjugate acid will hydrolyze. Okay, you will learn it in detail in class 11. But as of now, you can understand it like this. Here it is only acid. So normal acid does not mean it will undergo hydrolysis, because what will undergo hydrolysis here? CH3COO minus, like this, here also. Why Na2CO3 will hydrolyze? Because you have two things in Na2CO3. What two things you have in Na2CO3? CO3 minus is coming from the weak acid. CO3 2 minus is coming from weak acid. That will undergo hydrolysis. Na plus is cation coming from strong base. That does not undergo hydrolysis. Always remember. Not all acids undergo hydrolysis. Hydrolysis always happen either for cation or anion. Hydrolysis happens either for cation or anion. Cation of weak base, anion of weak acid. Only these things undergo hydrolysis. Shreyas, is it clear? Aditi, Shreyas? Yes. Any doubt? Now, why this is the answer? K2SO4? K plus SO4 2 minus. K plus coming from KOH. H2SO4 coming from? H2SO4, both are strong base, strong acid, nothing will hydrolyze. Is it clear to all of you? Why can't be the three? Because, okay, which among does not undergo hydrolysis? Okay, here you have NH4OH. Now see, because both are weak, my dear, it will undergo hydrolysis. They have asked which does not undergo. CH3CO minus will undergo, NH4 plus both will undergo, because both are a part of weak acid and weak base. Is it clear? Meghna? Okay, please remember this part. This will come in the salt analysis chapter. Salt analysis in class 11. So if you understand this topic, that will help you. Like what all undergo hydrolysis, what all does not undergo hydrolysis. Let me take you one next step. Just last question. If this is undergoing hydrolysis, what will be the product? What will be the product if this undergo hydrolysis? Any idea? Just last, hydrolysis means breaking the bond and forming new bond with the help of water. No. Okay, I'll tell you. Hydrolysis of CO32-. What will be the product? Product of CO32- is H2CO3 plus OH-. That's why carbonate, whenever there is a carbonate ion, it will give you OH- in the solution. That's why I'm calling it as a conjugate base. Because if I'm using the word conjugate base, it should behave like a base. So how it is behaving like a base? If you take carbonate ion, it in water it gives you OH- ion. That's why it is called as conjugate base. Did you understand why people call it as conjugate base? Why we call something which is, when something, some acid is breaking, it gives you some anion. This anion is called as its conjugate base. Why? Because this conjugate base gives you OH- like this. Is it clear to all of you? This is very important concept. That's why, yes, no problem, Aditi. Does a weak acid and weak base undergo hydrolysis? Weak acid, weak base not. Anion and cation of weak acid and weak base undergo hydrolysis. Not weak acid, weak base. They're cation and anion. Understood? This is nothing but a proton acceptor. Proton acceptor is called as which type of base? Proton acceptor is which kind of base? Proton acceptor is Bronsted and Lowry base. Bronsted and Lowry base are called as proton acceptor. Okay? Okay, students. Could I move to next question? I am erasing all this. Okay? Yes or no? Okay, fine. Someone has asked one more question. NH4 plus plus H2O. Who all can answer? Please answer, students. Who all can answer this question? NH4 plus H2O. Very good. NH4OH plus H plus. That's why it is called as conjugate base. That's why it's called as conjugate acid. Because it is giving H plus. That's why it's called as conjugate acid. Is it clear, students? That's why we call it as conjugate acid. Hope you understood this part. Yes, conjugate acids give H plus in water. Conjugate base gives, but that is the definition of acid only. Acid gives H plus ion the acid has what we call as acid, which gives H plus ion in water. That's why we call it as conjugate acid. Hope you understood this part. This is completely new for all of you. That's why I explained. Is it clear to all of you? Yes or no? Fine, I'm moving to the next question. Now we'll go a little fast. Okay. Okay, fine. So this is the result. Don't worry. Good. Next question. Now you have some easy questions also. So attempt it properly. Sir, any example of conjugate acid? I told you, conjugate acid is like NH4 plus is conjugate acid, Ca2 plus is conjugate acid, and all the Fe3 plus is conjugate. All these are conjugate acids. Copper 2 plus is conjugate acid. Okay, students. Let us see what you are getting in question number 2. Okay, 1 minute. It's not showing result. Why? Oops, something went wrong in loading result. Just a minute. Just a minute, students. Just give me 1 minute. Okay, fine. Okay, do you want to know the answer of that question? I will tell you answer. Wait. Answer for question number 2 is, okay, just a minute. Fine. Question number 2, select the acid. 4 hydrogen atom is acetic acid, CH3COOH. But formic acid is HCOOH. So those who have marked formic acid, they are wrong. Understood? Okay, fine. Next question. This question, I think all of you should get it right. Organic weak acid. Please answer it fast, student. Anushka, options are formic acid, sulfuric acid, nitric acid, hydrofluoric acid. Formic acid. Will get full marks. So answer is formic acid. So answer is A. Oh, still some have done wrong. Answer is formic acid. Okay, next question. An aqueous solution of following compound which contains both ions and molecules is.
I think you need to apply concept here, in which case both ions and molecules are present. Sulfuric, hydrofluoric, nitric, and acetic. Okay, last 5 seconds. Good. The answer for this question is acetic acid. Let us see how many of you got the correct answer. Okay, students, weak acid does not dissociate 100%. That is its definition. Weak acid, weak base does not dissociate 100%. That's why, okay, fine. That's why you put the reversible sign. If you know, weak acid is something like this. Okay, this was the question. So, you know, weak acid, if I draw the acetic acid, this is acetic acid. I always draw the double arrow, because it is weak acid. And it does not dissociate 100%. That's why I write like this. CH3CO minus and H plus. But if I write HCl, you know, many people write double arrow also. But if you literally tell me to draw the double arrow, I will put the second arrow very small. I'll put the second arrow very small and first arrow very large. Why? Because mostly it's in the forward direction. So many people write it like this. Small second arrow, like big first arrow. That is H plus and Cl minus. It actually dissociates 100% dissociation. 100% dissociation. Almost 100%. That's why in a container of HCl, you will have H plus and Cl minus only. No HCl, because all HCl has already broken down into H plus and Cl minus. But if you have a container of acetic acid, you will have all the three things. All the three things means CH3CO minus, H plus, and CH3COOH. Is it clear to all of you? The same thing is applicable for weak bases. You will have anion as well as molecule. Students, is it clear to all of you? Yes or no? Okay, good. Next question. Okay, so now Vibhav is leading. Very good, Vibhav. We'll see. Momita Dey is also next to you. Which one of the following will not produce an acid when made to react with water? Think properly. You have 60 seconds. Which one of the following will not produce acid? So I told you one concept, like which all things are acids, which all things are not acids. On putting into water, what will happen? You have to predict here. This is a very easy question, and at the same time, you should also know the concept and apply it in other questions as well. Okay, why you want me to wait there? Why, Aditya? Okay, fine. Answer for this question is carbon monoxide. Carbon monoxide is oh my god. Only 11 students have done this right. Okay, fine, I'll explain. Okay, wait. Sir, options are wrong. How wrong is wrong answer, please, sir? Okay, B is CO2. One minute. Don't worry, students. I'll change it. If carbon monoxide is the answer is A. Okay, fine, I'll change it. Carbon monoxide is neutral oxide. Okay, it is neutral oxide. And rest all are carbon dioxide is acidic. All non-metallic oxides are acidic. If I give you NO also, acidic or neutral? It's also neutral.
Okay, I'll change the answer, students. Just give me 1 second. I'll change the answer. Fine. Question number 5th. Answer is A. So, question number 5th. Answer is A. Just a minute, I'll change it. Question number 5th answer is A. 1, 2, 3. Okay, I've already changed it. Don't worry. Now you all get those who. Okay, students. Don't worry, I've changed it. Now. I'm coming back to the presentation. Yes, I'm sharing my screen. So you can see screen now. Okay, so students, here you can see the okay, just come here. Okay, so here fine. So this is the next one. Be ready for the next question. Okay, now you can see I have changed the answer. Okay, students. So this is your score leaderboard. Vibhav is leading. I think all of you can see your scores now. Okay, next question is in front of you. The metal oxide which when react with acid will give alkali is? Metal oxide which can react with acid as well as alkali is? I don't think this question is very tough. Okay, Arya, you must have misclicked. Okay, no sir, it happens all the time. Oh, with few of you maybe. Okay, student, answer for this is aluminium oxide. Aluminium oxide is amphoteric in nature. So I think most of you got it correct. Aluminium oxide. Amphoteric oxide reacts with both acid as well as base. Could I move to next question? Yes. Okay, fine. Oh, Vibhav, this time Vibhav has not performed good. Vibhav, what happened? You don't know about amphoteric oxide? Okay, fine. Next question. Okay, fine. During ionization, metals lose electrons. This change can be called ionization, metal lose electron. This change can be called oxidation, reduction, redox, displacement. Ionization, what is ionization? If you understand that, then you can also answer this question. Okay. So, last 15 seconds. You know, this is a very easy question, and this will give you the clarity of concept. You know, answer is oxidation. Whenever any metal lose electrons, that is called as oxidation. Gain of electron called as reduction. Ionization is something when you remove electron from some atom, that is called as oxidation. Very good, oil rig.
oxidation is loss of electron. So what is what about auto ionization? Whatever ionization means loss of electron, that's it. Understood? Next question. Okay, you want to see the leaderboard? Okay, now. Fine. Now, very good, Monica, Aditya, Vigor, Monisham. Good. Keep it up. Next question. A salt in the solution gives a pale green precipitate with sodium hydroxide solution and a white precipitate with barium chloride solution. A is iron 3 sulfate, iron 2 sulfate, iron 2 chloride, iron 3 chloride. Please don't make mistake in this question. I didn't see chloride and sulfate. How? How come you? So what you have seen? Iron 2, iron 3, that's it. Very good, Aditya, very good. Yes. I just want to know how many of you remember this point. That's why I have added this question. Okay, fine. So the answer for this question is B. Okay, some are saying B. Let us see. B is the answer. Barium sulfate is white precipitate. Fe2OH mol 2 ice is green color precipitate. Generally, salt of Fe2 plus are green and barium sulfate is white. There is nothing called so close. Either it's right or wrong. Okay. So here again, Momita is leading. Good, Momita. Next question. Always remember iron 2 plus 2 salts are generally green. To increase the pH value, the neutral solution we should add. My dear student, please see the time. This question is very tough. I know that. So please see the time. Okay. So answer is C only. To increase the pH. To increase the pH, add base. To decrease the pH, add acid. Salt is not always true. There are some salts which on adding increases the pH or decreases the pH, but it is not, you can't generalize it. Yes? Okay, fine. Moving to next question. Are you all ready? Okay, this time. Oh, fine. Question is also there in the list. Yes. Okay, no change. Fine. So, be ready for next question now. Which of the following is not the base according to any of the theories? You have 1 minute 30 seconds. Please think about the three theories which I told you. Which of the following is not a base according to any theories? Please take your time. Any theories, not a base. How do people misclick? So why you are so in so hurry? I told you, please read the question carefully. You have mix and match questions. For some question you have 20 seconds, for some you have 120 seconds. So think about the time, but see the time and then attempt the question. Okay. You have 30 more seconds. Why you have put it as the most sensitive? Please reduce its sensitivity. It is just kind of hit and trial method. So Fine. Last 5 seconds you have. Okay, students. I think you all got the answer. First, we'll see the reader that answers. Okay. How many of you got it correct? 34 students got it correct. It is nothing but question number 10. Yes. Now, those who don't know the answer for them, I am explaining. MgOH hold twice. When it breaks, gives you Mg2 plus plus OH minus. It is, okay, 2 times of OH minus. It is base, but which kind of base? Arrhenius base. Arrhenius base, because OH minus it is giving out. So I'll write giving OH minus. Giving OH minus. That is Arrhenius base. And second type of base, what is, one is Arrhenius, one is? Okay, fine. This is a Arrhenius base. Now, coming to the next one. Ammonia. Ammonia is, ammonia when, if you take, give H plus, it will accept H plus. So it is a proton acceptor. Proton acceptor are called as, proton acceptor are called as Bronsted and Lowry base. Okay, proton acceptor called as Bronsted and Lowry base. At the same time, it has lone pair also. Ammonia has lone pair. So it is also called as Lewis base. Why I am telling all this, it is not required in this question. But with the help of this question, I want to clear all of your doubts. It is also a Bronsted and Lowry base as well as it is Lewis base because it has lone pair. Okay, fine. H2PO4 minus. So in no case, it is an acid. Okay, not base, okay, it is base. H2PO4 minus. Now if you see H2PO4 minus, when it breaks down, it gives you HPO4 2 minus plus H plus. So it is actually an acid. Which acid? It is Arrhenius acid. It is Arrhenius acid as well as it is Bronsted and Lowry acid. Always remember, Bronsted and Lowry acid and Arrhenius acids are same only. Whenever you get the Bronsted and Lowry acid, you will definitely get that as Arrhenius acid also. Okay, BF3 exists. Yes, my dear, BF3 exists. Okay, so this is Bronsted and Lowry acid. And so fine. Now, coming to the last option, BF3. BF3 is given, means it is exist. It exists. But if you all know that boron has 3 electrons in outermost shell. What is the atomic number of boron? Atomic number of boron is 5, 2, 3. It has 3 electrons. So it forms bond like BF3. But now its octet is not complete. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it is octet is not complete, so it will accept lone pair. Accept lone pair. So if it accept lone pair, if it accept lone pair, then it is called as which base? Which acid? Yes, it is an acid. Which acid? Accept lone pair. Which acid? Just see here. Lone pair donor. When it's a lone pair donor, it's a Lewis base. When lone pair acceptor, Lewis acid. Again, I'm repeating. Lewis acid is something which accepts lone pair. And base is something which donates lone pair. That is Lewis concept. Three concepts are there. Arrhenius, Bronsted and Lowry, and Lewis. How I remember? Arrhenius, A is the first letter in alphabets. So it is the first theory. First theory was totally based on H plus and OH minus. H plus donor is acid, OH minus donor is base. Then B comes after A, Bronsted and Lowry. It is totally based on H plus and H plus. H plus donor is acid, H plus acceptor is base. And L stands for, I remember it like this, L for lone pair. So lone pair donor and lone pair acceptor. This is my way of remembering or acceptor. You can make your own technique, own trick. No, why C is correct? Which of the following is not base? Okay, fine, it's an acid, but it can act as base also. How? H2PO4 minus can accept that H plus and form H3PO4. Then it is a base. It can act as base also. Understood? H3PO4 minus can act as acid, can act as base. No. This is H3PO4 is acid. But H2PO4 minus, you have H2PO4 minus here. H2PO4 minus. You have H2PO4 minus. It is H2PO4. It is, I think you can all can see it is H2PO4 only. H2PO4 minus accepts proton, yes. And it can lose proton also. It has both options. It can accept as well as it can lose. Understood? It can do both. Am I clear to all of you? Sure? This is one question which I wanted to explain in detail. Three concepts: Arrhenius, Bronsted and Lowry, and Lewis. According to which theory it acts as base? Very good question. Who can answer this part? According to which theory it can act as base? Yeah, Bronsted and Lowry. Because it accepts proton. Because it accepts proton. Understood? Understood? Can accept and donate, right? Yes. So it is Bronsted acid also and Bronsted base also. So isn't it interesting for you to know that H2PO4 minus can act as acid, can act as base. Bronsted acid also and Bronsted base also. Is it clear to you? To all of you? Yes or no? Sure? I'm moving to the next question now. Hope you have copied everything whatever you wanted to copy from this part. Or whatever you have found it new, whatever you found new. Sir, what is Arrhenius theory? Arrhenius theory is H plus donor is acid, OH minus means what is Arrhenius theory? When some compound aqueous solution of any compound which gives H plus ion is acid. Aqueous solution of any compound which gives OH minus is base. That is Arrhenius theory. Is it clear to all of you? Could I move to next question? Yes or no? Okay. Two switch, sir. What is two switch? I didn't understand. Okay. 683218. Next question. Okay, very good. So here, this time. Yes, students, any problem in this? You have 50 more seconds. I have explained you Lewis acid base theory in detail. And not just Lewis acid base, all the three theories. Now I hope that you understood the theory and you will apply it in this question. I think I am not muted. Am I not audible?
Students, can you hear me? Okay, fine. So we'll see this question how to do. So question is, this is the question. According to Lewis acid base concept, which is the correct statement? So a species in which central atom has completely opted cannot act as an acid. Okay, that is the correct thing, because Lewis acid base theory means lone pair. Lone pair acceptor. Okay, lone pair acceptor. So if it is already having a complete octet, it won't accept. Yes, I'll come to that. Why answer of why 3 is wrong? Molecule in which central atom has vacant d orbital act as acid. Yes, it is true, but not always. In BF3, there is no vacant d orbital, but still it can act as acid. So in which the molecule in which the central atom has vacant d orbital acts as an acid, but not always true. One is always true. Vacant d, later you will understand, vacant d orbitals, like orbitals which is d subshell, later you will learn s, p, d, f. So the d subshell is there, if that is vacant, they will act as an acid. But it's not always true. It is not always true. Okay? If you ask me PCl3 is also having a vacant D, but it does not act as acid. It does not act as acid. So it is not true. Answer is A. Next question. One minute. It's base. What? Ananya, please ask your doubt. What? Ananya, what its base means? PCl3. No, it's nothing. It's salt. That's it. Okay. According to Lewis theory, neutralization is the transfer of proton from acid to base, transfer of proton from base to acid, transfer of electron pair from acid to base, transfer of electron pair from base to acid. Lewis theory we have discussed in detail, so I hope all of you can answer this question very easily. And transfer of electron pair or transfer of proton from acid to base, what is the Lewis theory? Okay, neutralization. According to Lewis theory, lone pair donor is base. Lone pair donor is base. Oh my god. The answer is D. Students, why you are making mistake? Okay, see, I'll tell you. Don't worry. So this is the question. Try to understand, okay? Question is this. Don't worry, I'll explain. According to Lewis theory, neutralization is. I told you Lewis theory is lone pair donor. Lone pair donor is base. Lone pair acceptor is acid. So transfer of electron, when neutralization takes place, so lone pair will be given by base, taken by acid, transfer of electron pair from base to acid. Base answer. Is it clear or not? Yes, all of you, fine. Now, so you know there is a one type of neutralization you can't think of also. NS3 and BF3. It is a Lewis. Can you think what is the product? Can you think what is the product of it? No. Transfer of proton is nothing. From acid to base is the Bronsted and Lowry concept. BL concept. What is the reaction of NS3 and BF3? It is Lewis acid. It is Lewis base. you know, the product will be, this lone pair will be donated to BF3. So formula of that compound is like this. Later I will explain in class 11 to all of you. This is the BF3. Okay, I write like, we write like this. NS3 coordinate bond BF3. This is the salt. This is actually salt. This is the nothing but coordinate bond. You must have heard about coordinate bond. Yes or no? Coordinate bond only forms when there is a lone pair of electron. Coordinate bond. Coordinate. Okay, no worry, no worries. But you know, this reaction also takes place and it is a neutralization. Is it clear? Is it clear to all of you? I'm moving to the next question. No, NF3 does not convert it into BF3. NH3 donates its lone pair to BF3. There are three fluorine atoms in boron. In boron, three fluorine atoms. It has a vacant orbital. It is donated. It is same reaction like NS3 is donating its H plus, and NS3 is donating its electron pair to H plus. So you will get NH4 plus. It is the same reaction like this. You know how we can write this? Please mute your mic, all of you. How we draw this? We draw it like this. H plus. Okay, I'll mute it. 1 minute. Okay, so this is a structure of NH4 plus. Lone pair donated to H plus, that is the NH4 plus. Understood? If someone wants to know what is NH4 plus, it is drawn like this. Similarly, I have drawn BF3, NS3 dot BF3. NS3 dot BF3 is nothing but NS3 donated this electron pair to BF3. Same like NS3 donated its electron pair to H plus. Is it clear? What happened, Ananya? Any doubt? Ananya, any doubt? No, sir. Okay, fine. Moving to the next question. Okay, we'll see the leaderboard first. Okay, today result is very much, in every question, the result is fluctuating too much. I'm not seeing the toppers earlier who were toppers, now they are not in the front page. This means that, okay, now this, just see this question carefully. Spectator ion. Spectator ion, when you see in your life and when you heard this term, if you remember, then you will get the answer of this question. And hydrolysis of this is done, write the spectator ion. Spectator ion, for your information, I want to tell, because 25 and 27 I have already answered, spectator ion is something which does not change. Which does not change during a reaction. That is called a spectator ion. I would like to see how many of you get this question right. I want to see that. Spectator ion in this question. Spectator ion is something which does not change during a reaction. Okay. Jai Matadi. Yes. See how many of you are going to get correct. Okay, so answer of this question is 15 of you got it correct. Very good, students. Very good. My dear students, spectator ion is something which does not change in reaction. I told you hydrolysis will happen for anion and cation, which come from weak acid and weak base. NH4 plus comes from weak base. Okay. And CO3 2 minus comes from weak acid. This means that these both will undergo hydrolysis. If hydrolysis is happening, let's say I put NH4 plus plus water. So there is, now you don't get NH4 plus. You will get NH4 OH plus H plus. So actually your NH plus 4 undergone change and become NH4OH. So this is not the spectator ion. Spectator ion is something which does not undergo change. That is a spectator ion. If you remember, if I write CaOH whole twice plus HCl will give you CaCl2. CaCl2 plus water as a liquid. So here calcium is plus 2 and here calcium is plus 2. Both are spectator because it does not undergo any change. So we will cut this. Yes. Which does not undergo change. I will write this reaction again. CaOH whole twice aqueous plus HCl aqueous gives you CaCl2 aqueous plus HCl liquid. H2O liquid. Now, in this case, calcium plus 2 is a spectator ion, does not undergo any change. Cl minus is spectator ion. So, final ionic equation left with you is OH minus plus H plus give H2O. Why you are not getting H plus and OH minus? Because water is in liquid state. I told you, whenever something solid and liquid forms, you don't cut them. That are not spectator ion. Hope you understood this. Yes or no? Next question. Okay. Next question is in front of you. Which of the following reactant has both Bronsted acid and Lewis acid? Think. 60 seconds you have. Both Bronsted acid and Lewis acid. Both Bronsted and Lewis acid. Okay, Bronsted acid is something which donates H plus. So only option was D. Only option was D. Because it can only donate H plus. NH4 plus. None of them had H plus. None of them had H plus. So answer will be D. Is it clear? Last question. What happened, Aditya? NH4 plus Bronsted acid, which donates H plus? Copper 2 plus. No, copper 2 plus can't act because it does not have H plus. Okay. Why not SO2? SO2 is also not having H plus in that. That's why. Okay, last question. We'll see the leaderboard first. Okay, last question. Which of the following does not show acidic nature? Acidic nature. Which of the following gills cannot show acidic nature? H2CO3, CaCO3, HCl and HSO4 minus. HSO4 minus. Cannot show acidic nature. Answer is CaCO3. CaCO3 is the answer. Okay, good. Most of you got the answer. Students, any doubt? Any doubt? No doubts? Fine. We'll see the result of today's quiz. Congratulations, Prisham. Congratulations. Okay. If someone asks conjugate acid and conjugate base, it is nothing but like if you have NH4OH. So this is base. Base has a tendency to lose OH minus. Whatever other things you are going to get, that is its conjugate acid. Conjugate acid. Is it clear? Is it clear to you? Congratulations to all those students who are under 5. Laksh, NPS, Pranav, Abhiksha, Mumita, Ananya, all of you. Okay. Is it clear to all of you? NH4 plus and OH minus, that's the conjugate acid. Okay. Someone asked this. Ananya, I think. No, Ananya, is it clear? Ananya? Conjugate acid. This is conjugate acid only, Ananya. Like, when you have a base, that will, whatever the cation it will form, that is a conjugate acid. Understood? Let's say you have HCl. Let's say you have Any OH when break, it will form Na plus and OH minus. This is its conjugate acid. Understood? Base when breaks, whatever cation will form other than OH minus is its conjugate acid. Okay, any other doubt? No? Okay, students, thank you. Hope you learned something today.